Portela's ends, and Rishima starts.
Portela translated
basically means a gateway. So this is actually known as Portela's de Rishida, or the gateway to Rishida, which is the other little hamlet just 150 meters away from here.
On our last full day in Portugal, Paul and I walk around Portela's. Both sides of his family go back centuries in this little village, working the lands to produce foodstuff, wine, and olive oil. And as millers, they ran the mill to produce corn and wheat flour.
We're brothers and sisters. We're brothers. And this he housed an oil extraction press in here. So come around October when we harvest the oil, olives. This would be a beehive activity for about 2 or 3 weeks. It was constantly working. 24-hour day shifts in which they would be pressing on the olives with olive oil. And at the back, you also used to have a still.
With the rise of urbanism and more rural people moving to the cities, it's not uncommon to see abandoned houses and untilled land.
This here is an old grape crushing pit and press. So the grapes will be brought in through that window, actually through the window as well, usually. Dumped in here, people would stomp on the grapes to crush them. Not with their hands, but with their feet. Not quite like that, but anyways. And then they would let it ferment for a little while. And after, they would extract all the juice. And they would pile up all the mash underneath that press with that round screw. Of course, the screws are going to be round anyways. That's besides the point. And then that thing would be turned down, and there would be a couple men, three, four men sometimes. They have a handle on that top section, and it's just a couple-long kind of a process. And they'd be just crushing down on the grape mash, to extract the maximum amount of juice possible.
We stopped by his old primary school, a one-room schoolhouse.
This is the school I went to for 2 years. I was here for grade 2, 3. A bit of 4, if I'm not mistaken. Grade 1, I was actually thrown into a private school, which was more like a prison than anything else. What can I say? It was a one-room school, pretty well. I mean, there was 4 or 5 different classes, but they were all one-room classes, one-room schools. Maybe grade 1 to grade 4, all in the same class.
Did you make friends here?
Yeah, I had friends. Of course I had friends. No, it doesn't work anymore. Nice little feature though.
What about those cars?
They call them. They refer to those cars when they first started coming out as the coffins. The reason why they call them coffins is because you don't need a driver's license to have one of those cars. And they were marketed primarily to the retired, old retired people. And they never had a drive. They never that probably don't even know how to read. And they had a little bit of money. They would sell for about maybe around $20,000. And they were tired being on their little bicycles or on their little mopeds going around the city, and they want something a little bit more comfortable to ride around up in. And that's, so that was good. These people just came out on the street not knowing how to drive. They didn't need a driver's license, and they just go out driving and create a lot of havoc for initially. Get hold of their these retirees' pensions. Because they spend about $20,000 for one of those things, and then they go out maybe 2 or 3 months later, they'd be dead because they come home from a car accident.
Come on.